until the philosophy which hold one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned. Everywhere is war. It's a war that until they're no longer first class and second class citizens of any nation.
September 3rd, 1939.
This is London. You will now hear a statement by the Prime Minister.
I am speaking to you from the Cabinet Room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British Ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note, stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently, this country is at war with Germany.
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
It has been decided to start evacuation of school children and other priority classes as already arranged under the government scheme. The scheme applies to the following classes: children, younger children accompanied by their mothers or other responsible persons, mothers, blind persons, and cripples whose removal is feasible. The plans are all ready for operation, and they have been well rehearsed. If you live in one of the areas mentioned and have a child of school age and wish to have him evacuated, you should send him to school tomorrow, Friday, with hand luggage containing the child's gas mask, a change of underclothing, night clothes, half shoes, spare stockings or socks, a toothbrush, a comb, towel, soap, face cloth, handkerchief, and if possible, a warm coat or Macintosh, a packet of food for the day. School children will be taken by their teachers to homes in safer districts, where they will be housed by people who have already offered to receive them and look after them. All parents of school children are strongly urged to let their children go. Parents will be told where their children are as soon as they reach their new homes. Mothers and other persons in charge of children below school age should take hand luggage with the same equipment for themselves as their children. As for school children, the names of the children should be written on strong paper and sewn onto their clothes. No one can take more than a little hand luggage.
During the early days of the war, 827,000 children and 524,000 mothers with preschoolers were evacuated from high-risk areas. Within 6 months, the majority had returned home, prepared to risk the bombs rather than deal with the unfamiliar and often hostile environment. In May of 1940, the British government began a scheme to ship children to the United States and Canada. Nearly 3,000 had left their shores when, on September 17th, the city of Benares was attacked and sunk in the North Atlantic, with the loss of 74 children.
My sister and I remember still a tulip garden by an old Dutch mill, and the home that was all our own until. But we don't talk about that. My sister and I recall the fishing schooners pulling in to shore, and the dog cart we drove in days before. But we don't talk about that. We're learning to forget the fear that came from a troubled sky.
No peace.
quiet, we find it necessary. And we know we shall win, as we are confident in the victory of good over evil.